The holidays are over. It is a new year. We've all traveled around the country, spent time with our families, and we're all pretty wiped out. And that includes my writers. They have to write hundreds of jokes every day just to get to the 10 or 12 we use in the monologue. And honestly, a lot of those jokes, they just aren't good. Sometimes I think they throw in a few stinkers on purpose just to fill the page and meet the assignment. But just because they're recovering from the holidays, that doesn't mean we can tolerate laziness, which means it's time for another surprise inspection. Here's how this works. I'm gonna read some real jokes, really submitted by my writers, that are unusable for the show. Some are dumb, some are offensive, some are just insane. Most importantly, my writers don't know we're doing this, and because a lot of them don't watch the show, they'll never know. So let's get started. Three Democratic senators recently called on federal regulators to require airlines to carry EpiPens as part of airplane emergency kits. And why not? I heard you can get them for peanuts. That was Brian. And I know people have a really good sense of humor about peanut allergies, so do write your letters to him. Health officials in North Carolina have launched an investigation after nearly 250 cases of norovirus may be linked to one sushi restaurant. Customers realized they were sick the moment they checked their tempura. That was Ian, everybody. And that was the satisfied face he made when he realized tempura sounded a little bit like temperature. Today was National Apricot Day, and it's no surprise it takes place during dry January. Did my mic go out? That was written by Matt, everybody. There's Matt. Wow. You guys, it would be so awkward if Matt was, like, here. What's that? He is here? Somebody go get the shame bell from Game of Thrones. According to a new survey, 80% of Americans said that they use food as a way to relieve stress, and I think you know what the ladies picked. Would you feel better about that if one of our women writers wrote it? Well, bad news, they didn't. Ladies' man, Mike Scollins. Today was National Hard Candy Day, so shout out to the one that makes me hard. Same dude. How many more? 50? The New York Post published a photo yesterday of a man eating a whole lobster in the New York City subway. And, oh no, sir, that's not melted butter. Wait, what is wrong? I don't understand. I'm like, here's his joke, and you're like, oh! And then I'm like, here he is, and you're like, woo! New York Governor Kathy Hochul spoke today at the New York State Police Academy graduation ceremony. We'd show a pic, but they all had their cameras off. Today, all right, I'm just gonna warn you in advance. Matt wrote this one. What's wrong? Why? Matt was like, I'm gonna come in today. I'm like, it's your funeral. Meanwhile, he's like getting a parade. Here's the thing, if you hate it, boo, and that's how he'll learn. Today was National Heroes and Heroines Day, so I had one of each. You're not allowed to do the axe outs. Oh, guys, this is actually very interesting. You guys, there was one story in the news this week that all of my writers felt compelled to write a joke on. Each one of them thought, oh, I am the only one that realizes there's something funny about this story, not realizing that every one of them knew there was something funny about this story. I think you'll understand why when you hear the setup. NASA yesterday released new photos of Uranus from the James Webb Space Telescope. But it's still not powerful enough to see your penis. NASA yesterday released new photos from the James Webb Space Telescope of Uranus with its Zeta ring visible. Wow, I guess it's never heard of Cottonelle wipes. God, it's so awful. There's literally no way anyone would applaud that person. Remember the joke. And don't then see the person and get all excited and start to clap. Remember the Cottonelle wipes joke about the visible Zeta ring and how correctly all of you were collectively disgusted by that effort. And now try to react when I show you the face of the person who did it. You all get what you deserve. NASA yesterday released new photos from the James Webb Space Telescope of Uranus, according to a new email from your dad with a photo of the family dog's butt. Give it up for Allie, everybody. You know, a lot of times after surprise inspection, people will comment on the YouTube page, why are you only showing the jokes that the guys wrote? What about the women? More often than not, the women write good jokes. I'm glad you're as excited about that news as you are about Matt's jokes. See, you've ruined applause. Now it's meaningless. Let's see what else is in the news. Oh, NASA yesterday released new photos of Uranus from the James Webb Space Telescope, but it's still gonna use older ones on its Grindr page. That dude. And you know what? You know what the most shocking thing is? You know who is too smart to fall for the Uranus joke? Ian. Give it up for Ian, everybody. This has been Surprise Inspection.